During the last ice age, between 20,000 and 11,000 years ago, there were a variety of animals that lived on Earth. Some of these were animals that are now extinct. These include the mammoth, the mastodon, the saber-toothed cat, and surprising animals like a woolly rhinoceros. Other animals survive to today, like wolves, caribou, muskox, and even some smaller animals like gophers and field mice. There were also a variety of bizarre mammals that lived during the last ice age. These included the giant beaver and sloths, as well as very large members of the same group that now includes armadillos, called glyptodonts. At the end of the last ice age, about 11,000 years ago, a variety of large-bodied mammals went extinct. These included things like the mammoth, the mastodon, and the short-faced bear. Humans may have contributed to these extinctions through arriving on new continents and overhunting animals that weren't used to human presence. Other animals may have gone extinct due to the climate change that occurred at the end of the last ice age. Many may not have been able to deal with the increase in global temperatures as they were adapted for really cold climates. Many animals that lived during the last ice age had a variety of adaptations for surviving the cold. One very notable example is the very thick layers of fat that mammoths had compared to modern African and Asian elephants. This fat may have been up to 4 inches thick. Others, like the woolly rhino, had a thick layer of fur, which we don't see in any modern rhinoceroses, and this allowed them to survive the really low temperatures typical of the last ice age. You may be wondering why ice age mammals got so big, and the answer is because it was cold. It turns out that the bigger you are, the easier it is to retain your own body heat. There are a variety of ways that we study the lives of Ice Age mammals. First thing, we need to know when they lived. And to do this, we use radiocarbon dating. This is a method that tells us when the bones were formed. We can also use the chemical composition of their bones. This tells us, for example, what types of plants they may have been eating or what types of prey they may have been taking down. We can also study the conditions of their bones and teeth, and this can tell us when they were born, when they died, and many of the things that happened to them in between.